League football at the expense of Tottenham in your stadium will be unbearable, unthinkable. What? How would you sum up the importance of this game on behalf of you and the players?
We are talking about an important game for many different situations. And the first, I think, the most important thing that we are playing this game for an important target and a place in Champions League. I think that this has to be the first thing to try to win this game. And for sure, we know very well. I know very well the importance of for our fans about this this derby, no? North London derby, and this is the first time that Tottenham is playing this this game in their own stadium and with the people. We know this, but at the same time, I think that my players, I continue to tell that we have to enjoy this moment, because to arrive and two games to go with an important target, to play an important target like a place in the Champions League, it means that we are doing a good job. The job has not finished. And we have to try to get 3 points. To get 3 points tomorrow against Arsenal, it won't be easy because we are talking about a really good team, a well-organized team. Arteta, I think, is doing a really good job, and he's managing. He's in charge for 2 years and a half, maybe, no? And he had the possibility to work to improve his team. But at the same time, to stay in this position for us at this moment of the season has to give us a big push, and to try to get 3 points on Thursday.
Have you got any fresh injury concerns ahead of this game, or any players returning from injury?
No, the situation is the same of the last game, the game before Liverpool. Reguilón is not available, and I don't think he can recover. There is only 10 days to go, and we are with the same players that we faced Liverpool. who know me, you know me, and know very well that I want to win. I want to win every game, and I try to transfer this this my thought to my players. And for sure, when I stay in one team, when in a club, my aspiration, my desire to fight to win the title. And to win the league in England is not simple, it's not easy. And Guardiola said that Liverpool won one league in 30 years, no, maybe. And it shows that it's not simple. Maybe sometimes it's easier to win Champions League or UEFA League or other competition than to win the league in England, because in England you have to face really monsters, okay? But after the game against Liverpool, the good answer that I had and was that my players were disappointed at the end of the game, and because they felt the possibility to win the game, and we analyzed the game the day after, and for sure, if there was a team that deserved to win and the chance created to win was Tottenham and not Liverpool. I think in this game, Liverpool, I think also Klopp understood that he gained 1 point, not lost 2 points. At the same time, I think Jurgen is an intelligent person, he's very clever. He was a bit frustrated after the game. But at the same time, I think that for us, for a top coach, but for every coach, it's important to learn that after the game, it's important to be focused on your team and not your opponent. Because if you are focused on your opponent, it means that you want to find an excuse or an alibi because your job didn't well or something was wrong.
Thanks, Paul.
Yeah. Roger.
Yeah, but to speak now about what happened in the past, I think that it's not useful. For sure, was very strange that our game was postponed for COVID, and Arsenal didn't have one player with COVID. I think COVID. We lost a game 3-0, and because Premier League didn't want to move our game when we had 9 players, 10 players with COVID. Yeah, I think that at that time was unfair what happened at that time. But now this is the past, and we have to be focused on the present. And to try to get the best result, and I think that this could be a good chance for us to get 3 points against the whole team, because if we played in January, maybe they were without many players because they were committed in Africa Cup, no, and injuries, and yeah. I think football is wonderful. Also, this type of game is right to play with the two teams, with all the players available. But personally, and in my mind, when I decided to be in charge with Tottenham, I knew very well at that time which situation was in front of me, because the team was maybe ninth in the table, no, and only 15 points, but in these 15 points, 9 points in the first 3 games, and then only 6 points in the rest of 7 games. I knew very well that the situation wasn't good, and only a crazy at that moment can imagine that with the 2 games to go, now we are in the race for a place in Champions League. And the club didn't ask me, we are appointing you to go for a place in Champions League or for a place in UEFA. I think they appointed me to try to improve the situation. And now I think that we have to be proud that after a difficult season in many aspects for the club, we are in this race, and in my opinion, in my mind, it's always a failure when I don't win, and because I'm used to try to fight for something important, to have a chance to compete with other team for to win trophy, to win a title, and when arriving in Tottenham, and I was sure that it was very, very difficult, no, the situation. But I tried to improve. I worked very hard with my staff, with the players, to improve the team and to create something, to create a base. And I think that we did this.
Thanks, Roger. Ali.
But honestly, and for the coach, it's not simple, it's not easy. And after the game, you have to try to keep your head cool, no? And sometimes it's not simple, it's not easy, and many times. If you remember also in this season happened, no? That when I was disappointed for a bad result, and I was disappointed with myself, with my players, and not to, when we lost against Burnley, and if you remember, I gave it to myself, no? The fault about the defeat, about sometimes we are a bit frustrated, especially when you arrive at the end, you know, of the season, and you understand that a bad result, a bad game, can change an important target for you. And but I repeat, and I have great respect for Jürgen, and I know that he respects me a lot, and this is a good chance for him, for me also, for all the coaches to understand and to learn that during the game, and you never have to speak about your opponent. It's important to be focused on your team, in the situation that maybe you could do better, and to speak about, I repeat, about your problems. But Ryan is a player that he has great potentiality, and physically he's really strong, and it's very difficult to beat him in 1v1. Defensively, I think also he reached an important level because he showed to great attention during the game, and in every game that he played, he showed with this. For sure, he has to improve when we have the ball, and because the wing backs for me are very, very important. And against Liverpool, we had a situation that the last pass, and if we I think that. We can improve in this aspect, and Ryan is a young player, and he's having a good performance. This type of performance has to give him confidence to believe in himself, because I repeat, we are talking about a young player with great space for improvement. I hope that in the past injuries stopped his growth, but now he's in a good form, and he's playing very well, and I'm happy for him because he's a really good guy, and he works very hard.
Okay, we'll go to Charlie and then finish with Jonathan, please.
I think that now we are a team with more organization under tactical aspect, under physical aspect, and now for sure this team has more football knowledges. And at that time, I arrived in November, and after only 1 month and a half, we tried to give a lot of information to the players, but you know very well, you need to have a process with your players to understand your football, to understand what you want to improve the mentality, also the physical aspect. I think that we had time to improve and to be a team stronger now than the past, yes.
How close then are this team to where you want them to be?
It depends on the target, and because I have only to tell thanks to my players, because these 7 months, they shown me great commitment, great behavior, to be involved 120% in every things that I gave them, and for this reason I repeat, and I have to tell thanks to them, and if now we are in this position and we have the possibility to fight for a place in Champions League, it means that the players improved a lot, and they made an important step forward. But for sure, and there are space for improvement, but you have to know for which target you have to play.
Thanks, Charlie. Johnny?
Hi. It's happened again on Thursday. You played again on Sunday at 12 o'clock. That's obviously a very quick turnaround. Any complaints to that schedule?
Yeah, but if I complain, and then I did the same like other coaches in the past, you understand? And if you remember, when Arteta complained, no, about this type of situation, I said that it's not right. Now could be my turn to complain, because to play on Thursday and then to play on Sunday, and the first game, because I repeat, and you could play also Sunday, but wait and put the game, the last game, no, and to give us a bit of rest more. But sometimes it's very difficult to understand Premier League decision, but if the club accept this type of decision, I have to accept this type of decision. And but for sure, a top club has to pay great attention to the fixtures, because before to play the game, you don't think that this type of situation can bring you in trouble. After the game, when you realize that maybe this situation could be affect the result, you are angry, but it's late. You have to be angry before, and I think in this aspect the club has to pay more attention on this aspect. I repeat, this is not but if you want to, I repeat, you want to win, and you have to take care about every details, because the details move the final result.
Thanks, Johnny. Okay, we'll end the broadcast section there. We'll start with a 12 p.m. embargo for Wednesday.